Hello friends, in previous video we had studied the saving in conductor material. In that video we have studied that if we consider one transformer to be two winding transformer and if we use the same transformer as the auto transformer, then in case of auto transformer there is a saving in the conductor material. In this video we are going to study how to solve the problem based on the saving in conductor material. The problem on the saving in conductor material can be stated as 11,500 by 2,300 volt transformer is rated at 100 kVA and as a two winding transformer. If the windings are connected in series to form an auto transformer, what will be the possible voltage ratio and output? Also calculate the saving in conductor material. Now the first step to solve this problem is to write down the given data. So first let us write down the given data. The given data in the problem is V1 is equal to 11,500 volt, V2 is equal to 2,300 volt and the kVA rating of transformer is 100 kVA. Now let us see what we have to find in this problem. In this problem, we have to find alpha A, then 1 divided by alpha A, that is saving in conductor material, and third is rated kVA. Now let us find the solution to this problem. Now if we read the problem carefully, it is mentioned that the transformer of rating 11,500 by 2,300 volt is initially used as the two winding transformer. Now let us find the rated primary current and secondary current for this two winding transformer. Hence the formula for finding the current at the primary winding is equal to S divided by V1. Substituting the values in this equation, we get formula for current becomes 100 into 10 raised to 3 divided by 11,500. Further solving this equation, we get hence the value of current I1 is equal to 8.69 ampere. Similarly, let us find the value of current at the secondary winding. Current at the secondary winding having the voltage equal to 2300 volts is equal to S divided by V2. Now substituting the values in this equation, we get after substituting the values, we get I2 is equal to 100 multiplied by 10 raised to 3 divided by 2300. After solving this equation, we get the value of I2 as 43.48 ampere. Now these are the two currents when the transformer is considered as two winding transformer. Now if you want to use the same transformer as the auto transformer, then the two windings have to be connected in the series. When this transformer operates as the auto transformer, the currents calculated in the primary and secondary winding will not exceed the value of their rated current. Hence, these will be the currents for the auto transformer as well. Now if you want to find the total values, we have to consider two configurations, that is the auto transformer windings can be connected in two ways. Now let us see what is the first configuration. The figure shows the first configuration. If we see here, the two windings AB and BC are connected in series. Now it was mentioned earlier that voltage of the primary winding of the two winding transformer was 11,500 volts, whereas the voltage of the secondary winding of the two winding transformer was 2300 volts. Same voltages will be applied to the two windings connected in series for the auto transformer. Now while considering the first configuration, the voltage of winding AB is assumed to be 2300 volts, whereas the voltage of winding BC is assumed to be 11,500 volts. Hence, the total voltage which is applied to the HV winding will be addition of these two voltages. Therefore, VH is equal to addition of 2,300 volts and 11,500 volts, that is nothing but 13,800 volts. Similarly, the currents that were prior calculated, that is I1 and I2, same currents will flow through the two winding of this transformer. So, we have assumed that current in the winding AB is equal to IH, that is 43.48 amperes, whereas the current flowing in the winding BC is equal to I, that is 8.69 ampere. Now, the total current IL will be the addition of IH plus I. So, it is found to be 52.17 ampere. Let us solve these values. We have represented winding AB for 2300 volts. Similarly, we have represented winding BC for 11,500 volts. Now, let us solve the values for the voltages. Therefore, the value of VAB is equal to 2300 volts, whereas the value of VBC is equal to 11,500 volts. The total voltage VH applied to the HV winding will be addition of these two voltages. So, let us find the value of VH. Therefore, VH is equal to VAB plus VBC. After substituting the values of VAB and VBC, we get VH is equal to 2300 plus 11,500. Further solving this equation, we get the value of VH is 13,800 volts. Same value is represented in this diagram. Now, let us find the voltage ratio. Now, let us find the value of VL. If we see the diagram carefully, VL is nothing but VBC, hence we can write VL is equal to VBC is equal to 11,500 volts. Hence, we can find the value of voltage ratio as we know that voltage ratio is denoted by alpha A. Hence, the formula for alpha A can be written as alpha A is equal to VH divided by VL. We have already calculated the values of VH and VL. Let us substitute these values in this equation. Hence, the value of alpha A is 13,800 divided by 11,500. Let it be equation number 1. This is the value of voltage ratio. Now, let us find out the value of total loading. If we consider point B, at this point, if we apply KCL, we will get the value of IL is equal to IH plus IBC, that is I. So, let us write down this formula. Therefore, the formula for IL is IL is equal to I plus IH. After substituting the values of I and IH in this equation, we get IL is equal to 8.69 plus 43.48. Further solving this equation, we get the KVA rating for the auto transformer of the voltage rating 13,800 by 11,500 volt is given by S is equal to VHIH divided by 1000. Now we have already found out the values of VH and IH. Substituting these values in this equation, we get S is equal to 13,800 multiplied by 43.48 divided by 1000. Further solving this equation, we get therefore, KVA rating is equal to 600 KVA. We can also find the value of KVA rating by considering the LV winding. So, let us find the KVA rating by considering LV winding. S S is equal to VL into IL divided by 1000. Substituting the values of VL and IL in this equation, we get S is equal to 11,500 multiplied by 52.17 divided by 100. Further solving this equation, we get the value of KVA rating as 600 KVA. So if we see, if we consider both HV winding as well as LV winding, the rating of KVA of the transformer does not change. So the value of KVA rating is 600 KVA. Now let us consider the second configuration. Figure shows the second configuration. If we see here, the only change is that we have considered VAB as 11,500 volt and VBC as 2,300 volt. This had changed from the initial configuration. So depending on this, all the values of current as well as voltages will also change. So let us solve the equations. From figure, we can write voltage for winding AB is equal to 11,500 volts, whereas the voltage for winding BC is equal to 2,300 volts. Hence, we can write the equations as VAB is equal to 11,500 volts, VBC is equal to 2,300 volts. Now, VH is the combination of VAB and VBC. Hence, the formula for VH can be written as VH is equal to VAB plus VBC. By substituting the values in this equation, we get VH is equal to 11,500 plus 2,300. Further solving this equation, we get the value of VH as VH is equal to 13,800 volts. This VH is represented in the transformer. It acts as a complete input to the total winding. Similarly, VL is nothing but VBC. Hence, we can write the equation of VL as VL is equal to VBC is equal to 2,300 volts. Now let us find the value of voltage ratio. We know that voltage ratio is denoted by alpha A, but the formula for alpha A can be written as alpha A is equal to VH divided by VL. Substituting the values of VH and VL in this equation, we get alpha A is equal to 13,800 divided by 2,300. This is the value of voltage ratio. Now if we consider point B, by applying KCL at this point, we get IL is equal to IH plus I. Hence, writing the equation for IL, we get IL is equal to 43.48 plus 8.69. After solving this equation, we get the value of IL as 52.17 ampere. Now let us find the value of KVA loading. For the auto transformer of rating 3800 by 2300 volts, the formula for the KVA is given by KVA S is equal to VL IL divided by 1000. Now we have already found out the values of VL and IL. Hence, substituting these values in this equation, we get S is equal to 2300 multiplied by 52.17 divided by 1000. After solving this equation, we get S is equal to 120 KVA. Now let us find the value of S if we consider the HV winding. S is equal to VH IH divided by 1000. Substituting the values of VH and IH in this equation, we get S is equal to 13,800 multiplied by 8.69 divided by 1000. After solving this equation, we get the value of S as S is equal to 120 kVA. So if we see that, even if we consider primary voltage, that is HV winding, or we consider the secondary voltage of the LV winding, the kVA rating for both is same. Now next thing is that we have to calculate the value of conductor material saving. So let us consider the first configuration. Now in first configuration, the formula for the conductor material saving is given by saving in conductor material is equal to 1 divided by alpha A. Now from equation 1, we already know what is the value of alpha A. So let us substitute in this equation. Therefore, saving in conductor material is given by 1 divided by 13,800 divided by 11,500. After solving this equation, we get saving in conductor material is equal to 0.833 PU. If we convert this value into percentage, we get saving in conductor material is equal to 83.33%. Now let us calculate the saving in conductor material for second configuration. We know that formula for saving in conductor material is given by saving in conductor material is equal to 1 divided by alpha A. But we have already calculated the value of alpha A, that is 13,800 divided by 2,300. Let us substitute this value in the equation. Saving in conductor material is equal to 1 divided by 13,800 divided by 2,300. Now let us solve this equation. After solving the equation, we get the saving in the conductor material at 0.1666 PU. Now let us convert it into percentage value. Therefore, saving in conductor material is equal to 16.66%. Now, if we compare the two configurations, it is clearly seen that the first configuration gives better saving as compared to second configuration. Thank you friends for watching this video. Stay tuned with Ekeeda and do subscribe our channel Ekeeda. Thank you.